线上，
Name Lord Jesus Christ, we have our evening Bible study together.
我们一起来唱诗赞美神405首。
Let's all sing hymns and praise God 405.
405首。
Hymn 405.
我们现在要做一个悟性祷告。
We're going to have a prayer and understanding.
我们请大家低头闭目。
Let's bow our heads and pray and with close our eyes.
奉主耶稣基督圣名祷告。
In the name of Lord Jesus Christ, we pray.
在的天父，救主耶稣基督，我们感谢赞美你。
Our beloved Father, our Lord Jesus Christ, we praise and thank you.
在太阳下山的时刻。我们也放下世上的重担。
When the sun goes down, we've also put down the works of the world.
我们聚集全家人来到你的面前。
We have gathered our family before you.
我们要在你面前一起来认识你的话语。
That before you, we're here to know your words.
是吧？我们读经的进度是诗篇。
And our Bible study right now, we're studying Book of Psalms.
哇，每一首诗就是古人的对您的祷告。
And every psalm is a prayer of the people to you.
大卫说：“但愿我有翅膀像鸽子。”
David says, "Oh, that I had wings like a dove."
我可以飞过狂风暴雨。
That I can soar above the storms.
我可以回到旷野，回到安息之处。
And I can fly to the wilderness and fly to rest.
我们生活当中充满了许多的风浪。
Although in our lives we face many different kinds of storms.
我记得在2000年前您曾经走在风浪之上。
But I remember 2,000 years ago, you walked in the storm.
那是在你做一个长时间的祷告之后。
And that is after your long prayer.
所以今天我们来面对人生的狂风暴雨，面对人生的风浪，也是要借着这个鸽子的翅膀。
And today, as we face the storms of this world and storms in our life, we also need to use and to have these wings of the dove.
那就是我们在灵里面的祷告。
And that is the prayer that's in the spirit.
当我们闭上眼睛，就进入深山。
As we close our eyes, we've entered in deep into the mountains.
当我们闭上眼睛，就可以在灵里面，借着祷告与你相逢。
And as we close our eyes in the spirit, in our prayer, we can be together.
我们就可以躲到你的怀抱里面。
And we can hide in your bosom.
你告诉我们，我们在世上有苦难。
Lord, you tell us we have toils in this world.
可是在你里头有平安。
But however, we can find peace with you.
所以求你都赐给我们鸽子的翅膀。
So may you grant us all the wings of the dove.
让我们可以回到你的怀抱里面。
That we can fly back into your bosom.
我们恭恭敬敬地把今天晚上的信息交托在你的手中。
Diligently, we have given your truth and your teachings in your hands.
愿你能够开我们的心。
May you open up our hearts.
能够开仆人的口。
And also open up the mouth of your servant.
能够将道理说得明白，讲得清楚。
That your truth and teaching may be spoken clearly.
让我们因着你的话语得到人生的方向，生命的力量。
And according to your words, we can find the way and the path in this world, in our life, and have strength in our life.
我们在聚会之前恭恭敬敬地向您来祷告。
And before our service, we pray to you in this manner.
愿一切尊贵、颂赞、荣耀归你的圣名。
May all the glory and honor be unto your holy name.
Hallelujah, Amen.
Hallelujah, Amen.
各位弟兄姐妹，大家平安。
Dearly beloved brothers and sisters, may peace be with you all.
愿主的恩惠常常与大家同在。
May the grace of the Lord always be with us.
我们这个礼拜读经进度是诗篇53篇到59篇。
And this week, the Bible reading is from Psalm chapter 53 and also now to 55.
晚上我想用55篇来跟大家一起来分享。
And tonight we are going. I'm going to share with you from Psalm chapter 55 as mutual encouragement.
来看诗篇55篇的第六节。
Let's turn to Psalm chapter 55, verse 6.
诗篇五十五篇第六节。
Psalm chapter 55, verse 6.
第六节，我说：“但愿我有翅膀像鸽子，我就飞去得享安息。”请读。
Verse 6. So I said, "Oh, that I had wings like a dove." I would fly away and be at rest.
大卫在这边祷告说，他但愿有翅膀像鸽子。
Here David prays and says that he wished he had wings like a dove.
所以晚上我们就用有翅膀像鸽子我做题目，我们从这篇来思想三点。
And with this as the topic for a mutual encouragement, wings like a dove, I'll share 3 points.
第一就是大卫借着这个翅膀能够脱离狂风暴雨。
The first is that David to use these wings that he could escape from the storm.
第二，我们来谈，其实这个翅膀的鸽子就是我们的祷告。
And second point is we are going to discuss about how the wings of the dove is actually our prayer.
现在我们来谈这个展翅演游的结果是什么，就是可以得享安息。And
thirdly, we're going to talk about what it means when we spread your wings and fly travel far, and that is the teachings of this dove, which is we'll receive peace in the end.
那这是大卫的诗歌，他是在什么样的背景下面写这首诗歌呢？
What are the circumstances and environment of David when he wrote this psalm?
当然，55篇大卫没有讲清楚。
And even though in chapter 55, David did not describe clearly of which circumstances is under.
个人的一个心得，我的猜想，他的背景应该是在撒母耳记下的5章，当他儿子要追杀他的时候。
And according to my understanding and description, I think it's recorded in 2 Samuel when his son is trying to kill him.
他在逃命啊。
And that this time he was trying to flee for his life.
我们来看《撒母耳记下》15章的30节到三
Let's
十。
turn to 2 Samuel chapter 15, verse 30.
《撒母耳记下》15章30节到32节。
Chapter 30 to 32, verse 30 to 32.
《撒母耳记下》15章30节到32节。
Chapter 15, verse 30 to 32.
大卫蒙头赤脚上橄榄山，一面上一面哭。跟随他的人都蒙头哭着上去。31，有人告诉大卫说，亚希多佛也在叛党之中，跟随亚撒龙。大卫祷告说：“主啊，求你使亚撒龙的计谋变为愚拙。”到这边就好，到31就好，请读。
Verse 30. So David went up by the ascent of the Mount of Olives and wept as he went up, and he had his head covered and went barefoot, and all the people who were with him covered their heads and went up, weeping as they went up. 31. Then someone told David, saying, Ahithophel is among the conspirators with Absalom. And David said, O Lord, I pray, turn the counsel of Ahithophel into foolishness.
所以我们看到大卫在逃命的时候，他先上橄榄山。
Here we can see when David was fleeing for his life, he went up to the Mount of Olives.
他一面上去一面哭，
And as he wept as he went up.
然后他又听到一个坏消息，
And he heard a really bad news.
就是亚希多福一个很聪明的谋士呢，也在叛党当中。
That Ahithophel, one of his counsels, is also in the rebellion against him.
他正为了这个事情在祷告。
And this is when he was praying for this matter.
那我们都知道，橄榄山其实就是耶稣升天的地方，也是耶稣祷告的地方。
As we know, the Mount of Olives is where Jesus had his ascension into heaven, and also where Jesus prayed.
大卫也来这个地方跟神哀哭。
David also came here to pray and wept before the Lord.
圣经上讲说，哀痛的人有福了，因为他们必得安慰。
The Bible tells us, blessed are those who mourn and are sad because for they will receive comfort.
那所以，我相信，55篇的背景应该，就是在这里。
And I'm pretty sure the setting of Psalm chapter 55 is here in 2 Samuel chapter 15.
所以我们看到他遇到狂风暴雨，
So we see that he has now faced a storm.
那他借着祷告来脱离狂风暴雨。
Through his prayer, he then is able to be released from the storm.
我们再回到诗篇55篇，我们把红线夹在诗篇55篇哦。
Let's put a bookmark on Psalms chapter 55,
我们回到诗篇55篇的第8节。
verse 8. Psalms chapter 55, verse 8.
诗篇55篇第8节，
Verse 8.
我必速速逃到避难所，脱离狂风暴雨。请读。
Verse 8, I would hasten my escape from the windy storm and tempest.
啊，这边它借着风的翅膀，鸽子的翅膀，啊，它要逃离狂风暴雨。
Here, with the help of the wings of the dove, he escapes from the storm.
那这是什么样的狂风暴雨呢？
What kind of storm is this?
这是死亡的狂风暴雨，面对死亡的狂风暴雨。
And this is the storm of death.
这是面对精神压力的狂风暴雨。
And also an enormous emotional storm.
这也是面对着好朋友背叛的狂风暴雨。
And also this is a storm of betrayal from a close friend.
我们先来看55篇的第四节、第五节。
Let's first look at chapter 55, verse 4 and 5.
55篇第四节、第五节。
Verse 4 and 5.
第四节，我心在我里面，甚是疼痛，死的惊慌临到我身，恐惧战兢归到我身，惊恐漫过了我。请读。
Verse 4, my heart is severely pained within me, and the terrors of death have fallen upon me. 5, fearfulness and trembling have come upon me, and horror has overwhelmed me.
突然之间，他儿子叛变。
All of a sudden, his son turned against him.
那所以呢，他必须要很快的时间带着家人逃离开耶路撒冷。
So, in a very short period of time, he needed to flee from Jerusalem with his family.
所以他谈到这是死的惊慌临到他的身上。
And therefore, verse 4, and the terrors of death have fallen upon me.
对，第五节说他是非常恐惧、非常战惊的。
And in verse 5, he was fearfulness and he's trembling.
我们都知道这个儿子要杀老爸，他一点儿也不拖泥带水啊，他是决心的要杀爸爸。
Indeed, for the son to want to kill his father, it's without any hesitation that he was going to do this.
我们都知道，当这个父亲的将军呢，要跟亚沙龙儿子征战的时候，这个父亲都一直在为儿子来求情。
Even the general of the father, was fighting with Absalom, and even at this time, the father was pleading with the general to have mercy on his son.
所以这时候他逃亡，他真的面对着死亡的狂风暴雨。
Indeed, when he's fleeing at this time, he's facing the storm of death.
所以你看到他上橄榄山哀哭，在求大声哀哭求神呢、
So we see when he has entered the Mount of Olives, he is weeping and he's crying, seeking for the Lord.
让我们想到主耶稣基督面对十字架死亡苦难，也是同样的情形。
It also reminds us that when Jesus Christ is facing the hardships and when he was facing the cross, he also was crying out.
主耶稣大声哀哭，流泪祷告，求天父能够撤去这个苦悲。
And the Lord Jesus Christ, he pleaded and he cried and plead that this bitter cup may be taken away from him.
真的，当我们遇到死亡的威胁我们要借着祷告来帮助我们。
And when we face death, we need to seek for help in our prayers.
我跟大家讲过，小弟这次去南非看到一个弟兄的这个车子里面的那个记录器车子的记录器记录到两个抢匪呢挡在他车子前面，在路上开到他的车子前面。
Was in the car in recording of a car camera that was recorded in when I was in South Africa. The car of a brother had recorded that two robbers had stopped in front of his car.
那这个弟兄他说他只有2秒钟决定，到底乖乖的举手，还是呢车子往左边开到土路路肩上去，然后超过他们赶快逃，他就有2秒钟需要做这个决定，因为对方的枪已经拿出来了。
The brother said he only had 2 seconds to decide at that moment what he could do. Either he raised his hand and surrender or turn to the other side of the dirt road and to drive away because the robbers had taken out their guns and pointed at him already.
他决定加速往前冲。
And he had decided he would speed up and to go forward.
然后呢，我就在这个记录仪啊，就是那个 camera 上面哦，看到他一直喊哈利路亚，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，一直喊呢。
And I could see in the car recording camera, you can hear him screaming, Hallelujah, Hallelujah, continually.
有时候必须要从那个对方车子车道去超车，因为，有时候要很危险的超车啊。
And you can see in the recording, there are times that he had to drive against traffic and to cut through different parts of the traffic.
那你就知道他在最危险当中。他说抢匪啊，追了他20分钟啊。
And at the most dire time, he had actually told me this robber had chased him in the car chase for 20 minutes.
分钟面对死亡的狂风暴雨，他只能够向神呼求。
And during in the midst of the storm of death, the only thing he could do is to plead and cry to the Lord.
感谢神让他逃掉了。
And thank the grace of the Lord that he was able to escape.
这不只是面对死亡的狂风暴雨，这个也面对精神折磨的一个狂风暴雨啊。
Not only that he had faced the storm of death, but also a storm of
我们来看
emotional
51篇的第
tribulation.
51节，
Let's look at verse 10.
55篇，诗篇55篇，
Psalms chapter 55,
10节，第11节。
verse 10 and 11.
他们在城墙上昼夜游行，在城内也有罪孽和奸恶，邪恶在其中，欺压和诡诈不离皆是。请读。
Verse 10, day and night they go around it on its walls. Iniquity and troubles are also in the midst of it. 11, destruction is in its midst. Oppression and deceit do not depart from its streets.
这边有几个负面的词哦，在城里面有罪孽，有奸恶，有欺压，有诡诈。
Here there's a couple of negative words, whereas within its walls there's iniquity, trouble, and there's destruction and oppression and deceit.
那如果你再回头看啊，《撒母耳记下》的第15章、16章记载，这个亚西多福啊，建议亚沙龙，而且亚沙龙这样做就是。啊，让他在光天化日之下呢，跟大卫十个妃嫔啊亲近。
And when we look back to 2 Samuel chapter 15, we can see that Ahithophel had advised Absalom to, during the daytime, to draw himself near the 10 concubines of David.
这个是乱伦呢，这个是很糟糕的一种欺压跟罪孽。
This indeed is great deceit and destruction and oppression. This is incest.
你知道这个，亚西多福这样做，主要就是让百姓啊，百姓可能会觉得这是你们父子之间在玩游戏啊，可能这个背叛是假的。我如果支持儿子，将来我自己倒霉。所以这是让百姓啊，亚西多福用这样的方法让百姓啊，父子啊，完全的绝类啊。
And Ahithophel had used this method as a way to fully tear apart the relationship of a father and son, to let the people in the land to see perhaps it merely is just a game that the father and son are playing.
那这整个计谋其实是非常诡诈的，非常邪恶的。
And all this scheme is indeed very wicked.
那大卫面对这种精神上的这种压，精神上的一种痛苦啊，因为他的儿子竟然对他的太太做这种事情。
David indeed faced an emotional torture because for his son to do such thing to his wife.
你知道，你网络上在谈哦，一个人知道自己的配偶出轨哈，他会有一个什么样的情形？
The internet tells us that when a person knows that their partner has become unfaithful, what are some of the symptoms they might have?
焦虑、恐惧、愤怒啊、沮丧啊，这种负面的情绪。
Anxiety, fear, anger, and sadness.
本来呀，两个人相爱啊，你会以为对方是忠贞的爱人，是贴身的朋友。
And two people, when they're in love, they think that this person is their closest friend and it is their only love.
是称职的父母亲，是孩子精神上的导师。
They're a good parent and also an emotional support.
那你会觉得你在配偶里的一个心目中当中，应该是独一无二，是不可以代替的。
You also would think that you are one of a kind and irreplaceable in the heart of your partner.
那但是呢，当一个人出轨啊，会打破这一切的信念跟期待。
However, when a spouse is unfaithful, all this will be shattered and broken.
那这是一种精神上的折磨。
Indeed, this is an emotional torture.
那这个事情虽然不是这个十个灰瓶啊的错，但是是儿子这种好像禽兽的行为。真的，这个是一个很大的一个精神上的打击。
And even though these 10 wives, it is not their fault. However, the son is like an animal, and it's a huge impact and emotional torture for David.
你说要逃离这种精神上的暴风雨，没有借着鸽子的翅膀，没有进到灵的深处，怎么样有办法做得到呢？
And if you want to escape from this emotional storm, if you do not have the wings of the dove, how would you even be able to do this?
你没有办法逃离。
You would not be able to escape.
那再来，我们就看到他第三个一个暴风雨，就是好朋友背叛的一个暴风雨。
And the third storm that he faced is the storm of a betrayal of a friend.
我们看诗篇55篇的12节到14节。
Let's look at Psalm chapter 55, verse 12 to 15.
52篇12到14节。
Sorry, verse 12 to 14.
12节，原来不是仇敌辱骂我，若是仇敌还可忍耐，也不是恨我的人向我狂大，若是恨我的人，我必躲避他。第13节，不料
13.
是你言与我平等，是我的同伴，是我知己的朋友。14，我们素来彼此谈论，以为甘甜。我们与群众在神殿中同行啊，请读。
Verse 12, for it is not an enemy who reproaches me, then I could bear it, nor is it one who hates me who has exalted himself against me, then I would hide from him. 13, but it was you, a man my equal, my companion, and my acquaintance. 14, we took sweet counsel together and walked to the house of God in the throng.
14节说，他们 sweet counsel 彼此在谈论的，彼此这个在神的殿中都在同行的。
Here, when verse 14 it says, we took sweet counsel together and walked in the house in the throng.
是我一个很好的朋友，
It's a very, very good friend.
是跟我平等的。
And this is a friend that is of my equal.
想不到你捅我一刀你对我再来最大的伤害。
I cannot believe that you backstabbed me and you are the one who gave me the greatest pain.
这个人到底是谁？应该就是亚西多夫。
Who is this person? I'm quite sure is Ahithophel.
我们来看历代志上的27章33节。
Let's turn to Second Chronicles,
First Chronicle，
First Chronicles,
27章33节。
chapter 27, verse 33.
27章33节。
Chapter 27, verse 33.
亚西多福做王的模式，亚基人互筛做王的陪伴。啊，请读。
Verse 33, Ahithophel was the king's counselor, and Hushai and Archai was the king's companion.
我们都知道，其实后来亚沙龙追杀大卫，主要的胜败呢，就在这两个模式当中的一个。啊，一个对立啊，一个抗争，两个模式之间的一个角力啊。
And we know that at the either the winning and the consequence of losing. Was in the king's
就在这两个亚西多福跟这个互筛的角力当中。
is Hushite and also Ahithophel's and in their
经
in
历
their role.
呀。那这边特别提到，这个互筛是王的陪伴，其实其他地方说王的朋友。
And here it says Hushai is the companion of the king, but is actually the king's friend.
那亚西多夫其实应该也是王的陪伴呐，就是常常跟王在一起的啦，也
But
是王的朋友啦。
you can also say that Ahithophel was always with is a companion of the king, and to because he's always with the king, so he's also the king's friend.
那为什么这里特别谈只有这谈谋士呢？因为后来亚西多夫背叛了大卫嘛。
And why do they only now mention is just a companion? It's because later on he betrayed David.
那你知道这个亚西多福啊？
Sounds
根据撒母记下的16章，他当时所出的主意，好像人问神的话一样。
And recorded in 2 Samuel, when the counsel, the advice that Ahithophel had given David, it's almost as if advice given by God.
他真的很聪明，他给的这个意见都非常的有果效的。
For all, he really was very wise, for the advice that he gives are all very fruitful.
所以，相信大卫也常常跟他谈论，以为很甘甜的。
And I'm sure David often spoke to him, and he felt very sweet in their companion with one another.
你会问，那既然这么好，常常在一起的朋友，为什么会背叛呢？
And you would think such good friends that's always together, then why would he betray him?
我们看两个经文来思想一下。
Let's turn to two verses and let's think about this.
我们看撒母记下23章34节，
Let's turn to 2 Samuel
23章34节，
23, verse 34.
这个在讲到大卫的37个勇士。
And it talks about the mighty men of David. 37.
那34节谈到一个人叫以莲。
And here it talks about a person named Eliam.
34节哈。34节，马加人亚哈拜的儿子以利法列，基罗人亚西多佛的儿子以莲啊，请读。
Verse 34. The son of Eliphelet, the son of Ashibai, the son of Mechahalite, Elam, the son of Ahithophel, the Gilonite.
所以你就看到有一个勇士，如果你仔细看39节，乌利亚哦。所以以莲跟乌利亚都是大卫37个勇士当中的一个。
And Elam and Uriah are one of the mighty men of David, the 37 mighty men of David.
那以莲就是亚西多福的儿子。
And Eliam is the son of Ahithophel.
那这个别示巴就是赫人乌利亚的原来的太太别示巴，就是以莲的女儿。
And Ashibai is actually Eliam's daughter.
我们看撒母记下的11章第3节，
Chapter 2 Samuel, chapter 11, verse 13.
撒母记下11章第3节，
So turn to 2 Samuel, chapter 11,
第三节，
verse 3.
大卫就差人打听那妇人是谁，有人说她是以莲的女儿，赫人乌利亚的妻拔示巴，所以呢，其实拔示巴也是勇士以莲的女儿，也就是亚西多福的孙女儿。
So here we can see the daughter of Elam is Bathsheba, which is actually the granddaughter of Ahithophel.
那我自己猜了哈，为什么亚西多福后来投靠亚沙龙呢？背叛大卫呢？
So this is just merely my guess why Ahithophel later on decided to lean to the side of Absalom
因为
and
他觉得
turn against David.
大卫真的在这件事情上面做错了，杀别人的老公，夺别人的老婆，这个老婆刚好就是他孙女儿。
And this is where David really had done wrong and committed wrong because he had taken the husband, the wife of someone else, and had killed the husband of Bathsheba.
那这个所以呢，亚西多福就投靠亚撒龙。
And that is why Ahithophel decided to be on the side of Absalom.
可是对大卫而言呢，就是一个好朋友背叛他的，一个暴风雨啊。
And this indeed is a, to David is a storm of a betrayal of a close friend.
那我们就想到主耶稣啊，被犹大背叛的事情。
And we think about when Jesus was betrayed by Judah.
耶稣说：“跟我一起同桌吃饭的，用脚踢我。
And Jesus
”没有听到声音哦，是不是 hang 掉了？Lisa。
That this is false.
She is false. Ken
I can
is
take over again.
okay, please. Yeah.
This says on the same table, he kicked me. 可以听得到吗？
现在可以了，现在可以了啊。所以我们就发现到，圣经上也提到这个大卫曾经问犹大不是耶稣对犹大说，你用亲嘴的暗号卖人子吗？
And Jesus also has told Judas that you use a sign of a kiss to betray me.
那这个对耶稣来讲，心是很痛的。
And to Jesus, this really pained him.
这是也是一种被背叛的一种暴风雨。
This is also a storm of betrayal.
我们中国话说哈，这个老乡遇老乡啊，那个两眼泪汪汪啊，就是有时候呢，看到好朋友，看到老乡啊，很感动。
And there's a Chinese saying that goes that when you see an old friend from before, you really will feel touched when you meet again.
但是有句话也说，老乡遇老乡啊，老乡见老乡啊，背后捅一枪啊，有时候你的好朋友，这个老乡啊。可是，在背后呢，却给你捅一枪啊！
And the saying also diverts then says an old as an old friend meets an old friend. The old friend could backstab one another.
所以，其实有时候最好朋友的背叛是最痛的打击。
Indeed, the greatest strike of pain is when betrayed by the closest friend.
对，这个亚西多福啊，那个真的。给亚沙龙这个乱伦的这个对大卫一定打击很大的，这个是最痛的打击啊。
I'm quite sure the advice of Ahithophel to Absalom to have incest indeed was the greatest strike and the most painful strike to David.
我们再来谈这个，其实祷告大卫在做祷告，这个就是鸽子的翅膀。
And let's continue to learn about when David prays, this is the wings of the dove.
我们都知道主耶稣受洗的时候，圣灵好像鸽子降在他身上。
We know when Jesus Christ was baptized, the Holy Spirit descended just like a dove.
那个鸽子非常的柔和鸽子的翅膀就是预表着祷告。
And the dove is very gentle, and the dove represents prayer.
这个祷告有什么特色呢？
What is the uniqueness of this prayer?
这个是一个紧急呀，面对暴风雨紧急的一个祷告。
This is a prayer that is urgent.
我们看55篇的第1节到第3节。
Let's turn back to chapter 55, verse 1 to 3.
55篇第1节到第3节。
Psalm chapter 55, verse 1 to 3.
神啊，求你留心听我的祷告，不要隐藏不听我的恳求。求你侧耳听我，应允我，我哀叹不安，发出哀哼。第3节，都因我仇敌的声音、恶人的欺压，因为他们将罪孽加在我身上，发怒气逼迫我，请读。
Verse 1, give ear to my prayer, O God, and do not hide yourself from my supplication. 2, attend to me and hear me. I am restless in my complaint and moan noisily. 3, because of the voice of the enemy, because of the oppression of the wicked, for they bring down trouble upon me, and in wrath they hate me.
这边提到这个是他在他第一件事情就是遇到困难，第一件在紧急当中呢，他先上山来祷告神。
We see that when he faces all these troubles and difficulties, the first thing he does is go up to the mountain to pray.
所以他求神留心听他的祷告。
So he asked the Lord, give ear to my prayer, O God.
又说呢，第三节说，因为仇敌将罪孽加在他的身上。
Because he had says, for they bring down trouble upon me.
所以弟兄姐妹，您遇到暴风雨哈，请您第一件事情一定要祷告。
So, brothers and sisters, when you face a storm in your life, the first thing you need to do is pray.
你知道在这个时候祷告多重要吗？
Do you know how important prayer is at this time?
你知道在这个时候，大卫每做的一个决定，都跟他将来的胜利有极大的关系。
Did you know that every single decision that David makes has great impact to his future?
他在这个祷告的前后，他做了很多很棒的决定。
And before and after prayer, he had made really amazing decisions.
比如说，那个祭司抬耶柜要跟着他逃亡，大卫说不可以，宗教跟政治要分开。
For the priests had wanted to take the ark with them while they flee. However, David has says no, for politics must be aside from religion.
那比如说，这个父筛他的朋友说："我要跟你一起逃亡。"他说："不要，你回去亚沙龙身边，破坏亚西多佛的计谋。
And just like Hushai, his friend, has said, I want to flee with you. However, David says, no, stay beside Absalom, so stay and with so that you can destroy their scheme.
”所以，我们常常建议弟兄姐妹，您遇到生命的暴风雨，第一件事情不是 panicking 哦，不是紧张，不是自己想办法。而是要跪下来祷告。
So, brothers and sisters, whenever you face the storm that's come into your life, the first thing you should do is not to panic, but rather immediately to kneel down and pray.
我今天听到一个姐妹在做见证，
And today I listened to a testimony of a sister.
她说，她开车上高速公路，可能有一个人不喜欢她开车的样子开车的方法。
And she was driving on the highway, and perhaps someone did not like the way she drove.
所以就开始孤立他，吼，在就是 road rage 就这个在旁边挑衅，然后突然看到他的车子面前，突然踩刹车。
And this person started to bully her on the road and started to have road rage and decided to speed past her and go right in front of her and have an immediate break.
一个姐妹说呢，她都不看这个人，她心中一直祷告神啊。
And the sister says she decided not to even look at this person, and in her heart, she continued to pray.
后来耶稣也保守他平安啊，因为在德州很多人都有枪的
And the Lord was able to keep her safe because here in Texas, many people have guns.
你看我这个祷告也是带着盼望的祷告。
You can see that this prayer also is a prayer with hope.
我们看第六节到第九节，
Let's look at verse 6 to 9.
第6节到第8节，
Verse 6 to 8.
我说："但愿我有翅膀像鸽子。"我就飞去得享安息，我必隐游住在旷野，我必速速逃到避所，脱离狂风暴雨。请读。
Verse 6, so I said, oh, that I had wings like a dove, I would fly away and be at rest. 7, indeed, I would wander far off and remain in the wilderness. 8, I would hasten my escape from the windy storm and tempest.
你看他在祷告当中，他带着一个盼望，他觉得但愿我可以得到安息我可以逃到旷野住在旷野我可以躲避这个情形。
And here, this prayer also has hope within, for he hopes that he could fly away, be at rest, remain in the wilderness, and to hasten his escape.
所以弟兄姐妹，每一次我们祷告我们都要。仰望神的帮助，盼望神的帮助。
So, brothers and sisters, in our prayer, we always need to have hope that the Lord will help us.
我这次又听到另外一个朋友的见证，他在几个月前得到圣灵。
And recently, I heard another testimony of a friend who, a couple months ago, received the Holy Spirit.
他说看到他的亲戚很多人得圣灵，他每次祷告都带着盼望，神也希望神给他圣灵。
And he saw that many of his relatives had received the Holy Spirit. And he had also hoped that he had this hope inside that he will receive the Holy Spirit.
那他开始讲灵言，他也不晓得是不是圣灵，是要等传道给他，给他 confirm 嘛，给他确认。
And he started speaking tongue. However, he was not sure, for he wanted the pastor to have a confirmation.
那他说了这个开始讲灵言之后，哇，他读圣经都会一直哭，读约翰福音哦，那个好像圣经的话变得很活泼啊，变得很真实啊。都一直感动他。
And he says after he received the Holy Spirit, when he reads the Bible, he's always crying and shedding tear, especially when he read the Gospel of John. And he felt so touched, and it's as if the Gospel had came alive.
我祷告，这个神的爱呀，大大的借着圣灵充满他的心呢。
And through prayer, the love of God greatly filled him and filled his
所
heart.
以每次我们祷告。我们的祈求都是带着盼望。
So every time we pray, what we ask for, it comes with hope.
那这个鸽子的翅膀，这个祈求，第三个，我们看到它也是带着信心的祈求。
And the third prayer, with the wings of the dove is to pray with confidence.
好，我们来看55篇的16节、17节。
Let's look at chapter 55, verse 15 and verse 16.
6节、17节。五十五篇第六十
16:17.
七。至于我要求告神，主必拯救我。17，我要晚上、早上降伏，哀声悲叹，他也必听我的声音。
Verse 6, as for me, I will call upon God, and the Lord shall save me. 17, evening and morning and at noon, I will pray and cry aloud, and he shall hear my voice.
你看哦，这边谈到他必拯救我，他必听我的声音。
Here it mentions that the Lord shall save me, and he shall hear my voice.
所以他要保持一天祷告3次的习惯。
And this is why he has a good habit of praying 3 times a day.
我们弟兄姐妹很多人也是一天祷告3次。
And actually, many brothers and sisters pray 3 times a day.
那我们又知道，信心其实就是祷告最重要的秘诀。
And we know that the secret to prayer is faith.
耶稣说，只要相信，信是得着，就必得着。在圣经里面这样讲。
And Jesus says, only believe and believe. Then you shall receive.
耶稣自己也这样 demo，这样子跟我们示范祷告。
Jesus Christ, he himself demonstrated this type of prayer to show
当
us.
拉撒路还在坟墓里头的时候，他这样祷告：“
When Lazarus is still in the tomb, he prayed like so.
说父啊，我感谢你，因为你已经听了我也知道你常听我。
It says, Lord, I thank you, for you already have heard me, and I know you always hear me.
”这个就是信心的祷告。
This is the prayer of faith.
那果然呢，他可以叫拉撒路出来行走。
And that's why he can call out to Lazarus to come out and to walk.
所以我跟小朋友讲一个故事
So I tell the kids the story.
有一次学生联会那我们不是都排队垫嘛，有一个小朋友在第一排的第二个位置得到圣灵，他就跟其他小朋友说这个位置有圣灵。
And SSC one time, they always have these prayer pads. And he received the Holy Spirit in the first row, the second prayer pad. And he tells the people, this spot has the Holy Spirit.
有很多孩子都在抢那个位置，
And so many kids fought for that spot.
跪在那个位置的都得到圣灵。
Because everyone that had prayed in that spot received the Holy Spirit.
这是他们单纯的信心呢。
This is their simple and pure faith.
这个是我们得福气的秘诀。大卫他在55篇的祷告，他必听我的声音，他必拯救我。
And this is how we can receive blessing. This is the key. Just like in verse 16 and 17, the Lord shall save me, he shall hear my voice.
那这个我们第三点最后来谈这个展翅演游，就是他用鸽子的翅膀，来好像鸽子翅膀祷告哈，最后能够展翅演游，那最后的结果到底是什么啊？
And we can see what is the final result of when you use the wings of the dove and you spread your wings and you travel far.
因为提到真的，后来神 听他的祷告，他这样的祷告，神都听他的祷告。
And you can see at the end that God heard and listened to his prayers.
我们来读55章第9节。
Let's look at chapter 55, verse 9.
主啊，求你吞灭，变乱他们的舌头，因为我在城中见了强暴，经正的事，请读。
Verse 9, destroy, O Lord, and divide their tongues, for I have seen violence and strife in the city.
啊，这边呢，就是，他祈求变乱他们的舌头啊，那真的你后来发觉到说，这个亚西多福的舌头啊，所说的计谋呢，被腹腮给替换掉了，被变乱掉了。
And here in verse 9 it says, Destroy, O Lord, and divide their tongues. Indeed, in the end, the words spoken by Ahithophel, then the schemes that he had is disrupted by Hushai.
那这个亚西多福本来说跟亚沙龙说呢，我带12000人，今天晚上我马上出发，然后呢，一定可以得胜利。可是乌塞就说不要，这个不是好的计谋。
And initially, he had told Absalom that we'll bring 12,000 men, and tonight we will have victory. But however, Hushai had said, "No, this is not a good tactic."
那乌塞讲了很多好听的话，最后亚沙龙听了乌塞的话。
And Hushai had sweet talk Absalom, and in the end, Absalom listened to him.
那结果他们错失了一个最好杀大卫的时机。
And therefore, they had missed the best opportunity that they had to kill David.
撒母记说呢，这是出于神定义要破坏亚西多佛的好的计谋。
The book of Samuel let us know that this was out of the work of God, for the Lord was going to disrupt this scheme, this really good scheme of Ahithophel.
有一次我在这个族群的上面听到有人问说，因为我们又谈到帮人家祷告嘛，有人问一个问题说，祷告有功效吗？
And I remember in a group chat, we were praying for someone, and somebody asked, how effective is prayer?
你看大卫在这个地方这样子变乱他们的舌头，真的他们的意见就不一样了。
Here you can see David asked to destroy, O Lord, and divide their tongues, and indeed, this carried out truthful, this carried out fully.
我们再读15节，
Let's look at verse 15.
55篇15节，
55, verse 15.
愿死亡突然临到他们，愿他们活活的下入阴间，因为他们的住处，他们的心中都是邪恶的。请读。
15, let death seize them. Let them go down alive into hell, for wickedness is in their dwellings and among them.
我们现在祷告不要咒诅了因为在新约，耶稣已经替我们死了，我们只可祝福，不可咒诅。
And in our prayers, we should not curse because our Lord Jesus Christ has died for us already. So we should not curse. We should only in our prayers bless.
但是在古代他们有时候会，我们有时候会读到一些这些但愿他们活活下阴间这种咒诅的诗歌。
However, in the Old Testament, we will still see Psalms that talk about let them go down alive into hell, things of this matter. That's still in the Old Testament.
您知道后来亚西多福怎么死的吗？
Do you know how, in the end, Ahithophel had died?
亚沙龙不听他的意见他就收拾自己的东西，回到自己的城市，就上吊自杀了。
When Absalom decided not to listen to his advice, he gathered his things and went back to his home and he hung himself.
这个最聪明的人做了最愚笨的死的方法。
And the wisest man decided to die in the most foolish manner.
我姐妹不要自杀
Indeed, do not commit suicide.
这边提到说呢，愿他活活下阴间。这个自杀的人真的会下阴间哦。
And here it says, may he go down alive into hell. Indeed, the ones who commit suicide will be in hell.
我跟弟兄姐妹讲到我在神学院听的一个故事
And I share with brothers and sisters a story that I heard when I was in the TTP.
就是有一个姐妹因为欠债的关系 没有钱还，他后来上吊自杀。
There was a sister that was heavily in debt, and she did not have money to pay off the debt, so therefore she hung herself.
那一个只是娘哦，到他们家来探访，看到哎，奇怪，他这个把一个绳子吊在门槛上啊，这么低，怎么可能吊得死呢？
And the deacon's wife then went to visitation to her house. And she had seen that she had hung this, she tried to hang herself at the door frame. However, the door frame is very short. How is it possible that she was able to successfully hang herself?
所以他就试试看，
So she decided to give it a try.
他要实验看看怎么回事。
She wanted to try to see what is the matter and how would this work?
所以当他把脖子套在绳子上面的时候，
When she put the rope around her neck.
当然旁边有人，然后他只是试试看。
Of course, there was someone beside her and she just wanted to give it a try.
他说：“突然之间呢，他这个地不见了，好像变成一个无底坑，他的眼前完全黑暗，有个力量把他的腿要拉到那个无底坑下面。
She said, all of a sudden, the ground disappeared. It was like a bottomless pit. And it felt like there was this power that was trying to drag her right into the bottomless pit.
”他说：“他喊哈利路亚，然后就恢复正常。”
And she screamed, Hallelujah, and everything went back to normal.
对他说：“哈，不是上吊死的，是被魔鬼拖下去的啦。自杀是被魔鬼拖下去的。
She says suicide is not because that she had hung herself, but it's because she was dragged she was dragged away by Satan.
”所以弟兄姊妹，不可以给魔鬼留地步。
So therefore, brothers and sisters, do not leave a foothold for Satan.
那不只是他的祷告，你看哦，这两个祷告都实现，而且他自己真的是。能够住在旷野得享安息呀、
And not only have these two prayers really have been fulfilled, however, he also can live in the wilderness and have peace.
啊。我们来看52:22，
Let's look at verse 22.
52:22，
Chapter 55, verse 22.
你要把你的重担卸给主，他必抚养你，他永不叫一人动摇。你说。
Verse 22. Cast your burdens on the Lord. And he shall sustain you. He shall never permit the righteous to be moved.
可是后来，大卫真的逃到约旦河的东北边去了。
And indeed, in the end, David was able to flee to the northeast side of the River of Jordan.
那逃得很匆忙，什么都没带。当地的人呢，就给他棉被、锅碗瓢盆、大麦、小麦。
And he was in such a haste that he didn't bring anything when he fled. So the people locally had given him pots and pans and also wheat.
真的，这个都他的体验哈、哦，你祷告的结果有鸽子的翅膀到最后
And
神抚养你叫你不动摇。
These are all the experiences that we can have is when we prayer and the prayer has the wings of the dove and that you are fervent in your faith and in the end you shall be delivered.
弟兄姐妹，您有面对暴风雨的时刻吗？
Brothers and sisters, do you have a time when you are in the midst of a storm?
那个暴风雨到底是什么呢？
What is the storm that you face?
那个时候你有鸽子的翅膀吗？
And at that time, do you have wings like a dove?
主耶稣，只要你祷告，有鸽子的祷告的翅膀，你必被主耶稣带到一个安息的场所。
And when you pray and you have wings like a dove in your prayer, then the Lord will bring you to a place of peace.
你在那边永不动摇。
And there you will be unshaken.
感谢主，今天我们就这样来彼此劝勉。
And thank the grace of the Lord, this will be our mutual encouragement for tonight.
现在来祷告，我们祷告15分钟啊。
Let us pray, and we'll pray for 15 minutes.
我会鼓掌来结束，我们一起来祷告。
Let's all pray in one accord.
大家也可以把麦克风打开，一起来祷告，奉主耶稣基督圣名祷
Also,
告。
unmute to pray together.
Hallelujah.